right. Hey, welcome back, Mechanical Pros. Got a great one for you today. I'm here with Quentin, and we finally maybe got our compressor cutter opener ready to roll. So Quentin's done a really nice job of getting the set up and did a little customization here and cutting open the compressors. Is going to be a fun experiment to be able to see what was the failure was of that compressor and teach technicians what to look for and what a diagnosis actually looks like when they open it up and look inside. So, Quentin, tell me, first of all, tell me what we got here. Tell me how you set it up and customized it and then what we're going to be cutting up.
Yeah, so this is actually a rigid pipe cutter. Okay, with the mule is what we generally call it, to drive a cutting wheel. So this is really similar to just like a regular pipe cutter that you would use, you know, to cut refrigerant piping or anything like that. It's just on a much larger scale and it's driven electronically. There's a hydraulic jack on the backside that will allow us to apply pressure on that wheel to the compressor. So as we cut through, we can continue to cut deeper as we apply more pressure. We had to build a little chassis here for the compressor cutter to sit on, because whenever we first got it, we put it on the table, tried to start cutting compressors open, everything was slipping and sliding everywhere, oil's going everywhere. Even though we have a drain on our table that allows all of the used oil to drain into the holes and into this pan where we can remove it and, you know, get rid of it properly, it's still an oily mess, right? And so we had to build this chassis, something to kind of hold these components in place. The way that we built it in such a way so that we can slide the little bracing wheels back and forth. So depending on what size compressor you have or which direction you have the compressor oriented, cut it, we can, you know, adjust for different size compressors.
All right. So this can cut up to 8-inch pipe. Does that mean we're limited to an 8-inch compressor?
Yeah, we're limited to an 8-inch compressor.
Okay.
So our VRV compressors are about 6.5 inches in diameter generally.
Okay.
So, you know, most of your Copeland scrolls, VRV compressors, all that type of stuff is going to fit on here.
Why industrial pipe fitter in lieu of like plasma cutter or something like that?
It's a great question. So whenever we're doing a compressor teardown, you know, we're trying to analyze why did this thing fail. One thing that we don't want to use is like a grinder or a plasma cutter, because that's going to contaminate what's inside of the compressor. So by doing it this way, we're able to cut the compressor clean and nice and not add any additional debris or metal or anything like that.
Or heat, really.
Or heat, yeah.
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 Okay. All right. I can't wait, man.
Yeah, it's going to be good.
So let's see what happens.
All right. All right. So the first thing that we're going to do in the setup process, we're going to grind down. There's a couple of spot welds around the compressor, just where the frame of everything that kind of holds the guts in place inside of this compressor. We have to grind those down to make sure that our compressor is going to roll smoothly on these rollers. If we learned the hard way that if you don't do that, that it's going to jump and bounce around and you're going to have a bad time.
So you just hit it with a grinder.
Yeah, hit it with a grinder, like with a little flapper wheel, and just kind of knock those down smooth so that it can roll freely. The next thing you want to do is put a level on the top and make sure that it's pretty close to level. It doesn't have to be exact. These little roller balls are adjustable. So depending on how big and diameter the compressor is, determines how much you have to slide these little rollers in or out. You slide them in closer together, it raises the compressor up, and slide them further apart, it's going to drop the compressor back.
Okay. And then you cut it open, you're going to get oil all over the place.
Probably going to get oil all over the place. So whenever we do a compressor replacement in the field with our technicians, we encourage them to drain the oil and measure it. But a lot of the compressors that we get in are from warranty. And so, you know, we never really know what we're going to find. But, you know, if we're cutting open one of ours, then usually it's pretty dry because we've already drained the oil, measured it, and sent it off for an analysis.
Okay.
But, you know, another compressor from somebody else, we don't really know. So it's probably going to be full of oil.
But you do have a drain in the table.
Yep.
To pick it up.
That's right. Yep. So it's going to drain down towards this drain. And at the end, we've got a little spatula. It's almost like going to Waffle House. Okay. You just scrape it out into the drain.
Yum.
What do they call it? Scattered, smothered, and covered. So let's get into it. So the first thing that we want to do, make sure the compressor's level, make sure that everything spins freely and it's not going to hit anything, because we've got a discharge pipe here on the side and we've got a motor wiring cover here on the side too. We want to make sure that that's not going to hit anything in the process of this compressor rotating, because as that wheel rotates, the compressor is going to rotate as well. Okay. So we're going to get it to a position where I like to start with the stickers on top. because that kind of gives me a baseline to make my first incision into the top. Just like whenever you cut copper pipe, you have to kind of get your groove started. Otherwise, you're going to walk off and it's going to spiral out and then the compressor is going to fall out on the ground. Okay? What we're going to do is put on our safety glasses because safety always comes first. All right. We'll wipe mine off so that I can see. And we're going to apply a little bit of pressure. We've got a little pump jack here that's going to drive this hydraulic. We're going to apply some pressure to the compressor. So right now we're cutting the top off the compressor essentially, right? So I'm going to get this pretty close. I'd like to make my cut a little bit closer down. So I'm going to try to slide it in a little bit and make sure that I don't hit anything. And so I'm going to get it as close as I can get it without hitting anything. And you also have to watch for this weld on the side here, right? So you don't want to try to cut into the weld. You're going to have a bad day. So we're going to try to separate the top of the can from the rest of the compressor so that we can get to the scroll plates, okay? So I'm going to get as close as I can without hitting anything. And that's probably about as good as it's going to get. I'm going to go ahead and roll it back up to the top so I can have a little bit of a baseline. And I'm going to go ahead and start pumping down my cutter. Give it a few good pumps once it's locked in. All right, so now we've got some pressure on that compressor. And now we're going to pull the trigger. We're going to rotate it one way. Yeah. Then we're going to push the trigger the other way. We're going to rotate it backwards, okay? All right. So we're going to make a small cut. I'm going to go ahead and back it up. We're going to do this a few times until we feel that the groove is deep enough that we're going to be able to just let this thing heave. I'm going to go ahead and apply a little bit more pressure. And you can see it's already starting to cut a little bit. We're gonna get a pretty deep groove before we just mare down on it and start letting it go on its own. So we got the top off the compressor now.
Yeah.
And a couple of things that catch our attention right away is this is our check valve for the suction line. Okay, and you can kind of see that it's just kind of littered with little bits of copper shavings. And then on the top of this scroll plate cover here, there's a milky black substance, okay? So I think this is gonna be a good one. So the next step that we're gonna do is we're gonna go ahead and start to disassemble the end of this compressor and expose the scroll plates, and we're gonna inspect those scroll plates.
Okay.
It's a little bit easier to work on, as we should be able to slide this on over, and then we can just lock the cutter down on it. That way we can work on it a little bit. Hopefully it doesn't get in our way. All right, that should keep it nice and secure so it's not rolling on us. Oop. So now we're going to take a 10 millimeter socket. I can't believe we haven't lost this, but we've got a 10 millimeter socket. Take this guy out of the way too.
That's my favorite one, by the way.
It's my favorite one too, man. I buy those in bulk.
Mm-hmm.
My favorite metric socket. So we're going to go ahead and try to pop this end cap off. So you're probably starting to see this isn't really a process you want to do. You know, if you're on your way to a date, probably not something you want to do to start your day. This might be an end of the day project because you're going to get pretty dirty and pretty nasty doing this. And we're going to hold on to these bolts because we're going to need them in one of the next steps.
And what plate are we taking off here?
This is just like a plate that covers the top of the scroll, top of the fixed scroll. So this portion that you see here is what we're calling the fixed scroll.
Yeah.
It's called fixed because it's in a fixed position. It doesn't move. It stays in one place. And then behind that scroll, there's an orbital scroll, which is going to be driven by the internal motor.
Okay.
So we're going to kind of hold this in place because we want to take it off and inspect it without it landing on anything and getting contaminated. Okay, so we could see some copper plating on the top of the plate of this compressor. Okay, if you look closely here at our valves, there's some copper plating there too. So this thing might have had a moisture issue, which That would make sense because our oil is milky. Okay. And if we did an oil sample analysis on this, they would be able to tell us how many parts per million moisture were in it.
Okay.
And things like that. So it's really valuable to do that oil sample. That's going to help you determine what killed the compressor. Okay. So this is the fixed scroll plate. I'm going to take my hand and just kind of wipe off there because I don't see any grit or anything like that on here. I do see a little bit of a...
Let's see if I can get a towel and wipe this down.
So first thing you want to do is make sure there's not any grit on there. If there is a grit, maybe take a picture of it so that you can show your customer. But aside from that, we're just going to wipe the face clean now that we've confirmed there's no grit. We're going to wipe the face clean. And we see a little bit of wear, but nothing really extreme. Nothing as bad as we have seen before. Okay, the scroll is still intact. We don't see any milling or anything really substantial on the scroll face itself, at least on the fixed scroll. Okay, but usually if you have an issue with the fixed scroll, you're going to find issues with the orbital scroll as well whenever you go to pull it out. So I don't really see anything really crazy here yet. So we're going to move on to the next piece. So far, what we found is it looks like the oil is milky, which tells us there's moisture. We see copper plating, another sign of moisture.
Yeah.
All right, so now, once we have that fixed scroll out of the way, we've kind of exposed some debris and some metal. We look down here at the bottom of the casing, we can see all types of sludge and metal particulate. Okay, mm-hmm. That looks like a slurry. That looks almost like an iron slurry mixed with the oil. It's kind of gray and shiny. It's really thick and muddy.
And you feel confident that wasn't from us cutting it open?
No, not at all, because we're not introducing any oil or any moisture or anything as we cut this compressor open, and we're not creating... The only byproduct that you see is a sharp little burr here.
Okay.
A smart person would wear safety gloves whenever they're doing this,
mm-hmm.
but you're probably going to you're gonna waste a pair of safety gloves in the regard that they're going to be destroyed after you do this. So maybe get you a pair of safety gloves that are dedicated for cutting compressors.
Yeah.
All right? So something that is really odd right off the bat is this scroll is really, really loose in here, okay? So it's like trying to fall out of the compressor. So we're just going to go ahead and let it fall. We're going to put that ring back in place. And so as I slide this out, I see the failure, okay? So there's the backside of our fixed scroll. It's got a major crack where it meets the shaft, okay? That is substantial. This thing was probably beating itself to death.
That thing was...
That's bad. That's really bad. That's among some of the worst that I've seen. So we also have some little copper pieces that are on the backside of this face as well. So keep in mind, as this compressor is turning several thousand RPM, whenever you've got this metal particulate in there, this stuff is absolutely pelting the windings, okay? Pelting the windings of the compressor, sanding down all these faces. It's making it a really bad life for the compressor, and no compressor can live in these conditions.
All right. Good job.
All right, how do I take this?
So you want to
hydraulic raise out, yeah.
So you just push down on this pedal?
Okay, gotcha.
And so we're going to modify our setup and put this as a foot deal where you can jack it up with your foot. But very nice job, John. First coat ever. It turned out perfect. That was great.
That's how you do it.
That was perfect.
Yep.
So it looks like it completely separated on the first try. So now we're just going to take the end off. We're going to take this sump off
and we're going to have a look.
All right.
Come here with that.
All right. So we got solid.
Coming out. Let's go ahead and take a look before we, So as we look inside of the sump, as I mentioned earlier, we've got three magnets down there. The purpose of the magnets is to catch any of that iron or any other type of ferrous metal that can, you know, really adhere to those magnets as much as it can.
Yeah.
And they can only handle so much. They're only going to take on so much. These are fully loaded. Okay. They are totally loaded with, iron from all parts of the compressor. These things are completely saturated with metal. They've got that metal sludge. This is really bad. We're going to take and just get us a little sample off of there. Wow. Yeah, this might be top two worst compressor teardowns I've ever been a part of. This stuff is just like what a mess. It's like a paste. This rotor assembly is a big magnet, okay? So a lot of the metal is going to be attracted to that rotor. So on the bottom, we see some more metal all on the bottom of that rotor assembly.
Yeah.
But we're going to go ahead and knock that rotor out of the bottom of the compressor. That way we can inspect it and the inside of the stator. Okay? So we're going to take a big hammer, and we're going to take a screwdriver, and we're just going to knock it out the end here. All right? And as you hit it, I'm going to receive it. All right? Bear down on it. So as we mentioned earlier, this rotor is a big magnet, okay? So as you can see, there's a ton of metal that's been attracted to this magnet. It's kind of sticking off of it all over the place like little stalagmites. You can see all that.
Yeah.
And if we look at the top portion, remember a minute ago we said it was more of a top-end failure? So where that bearing would reside, you can see where this section right here is milled down where that bearing lives, okay? You can feel a groove, probably a couple millimeter groove there. But if we take the rotor and turn it down like this, I like to just shine a flashlight up through the bottom of that shaft and just see if I can see light at the other end. It'll help us identify if there's a restriction in one of the oiling orifices.
So we come down here to the end, and it also helps us see the condition of the shaft, which it's going to be impossible to see this on camera, but there's a ton of metal and particulate throughout this shaft.
So all in all, we saw moisture.
Yeah, okay. I was going to go back to the moisture.
Yeah.
We saw moisture.
We saw a lot of moisture. And so anytime you have moisture in the refrigerant oil, it's diluted, right? So the oil can't function the way that it's supposed to. So everything gets hotter with moisture. Everything goes up. Every temperature goes up inside of the system as far as moving parts goes.
And you're not going to meter through this.
Well, if you're pushing water and a water and an oil mix through
with trash, yeah,
it's not going to be long for this world. So this system that this compressor came out of is in dire need of a system cleanup. Okay, because this is among some of the worst that we've seen. Will it get it? We don't really know. Right, this is one that got dropped off for warranty. But in a nutshell, that's what we do. That's what we check whenever we go through a compressor teardown.
Yeah.
So we can kind of come to a better conclusion as to what needs to happen for this system. So this system needs a cleanup kit installed, possibly the lines flushed. Would love to see an oil sample analysis on this one. We can tell that it's terrible, but just for kicks, I'd love to see what an oil sample analysis would tell us about it. What types of metals are in it? How much moisture it has in it? So this one may be a situation where you would need to change all of the compressors, because all of the other compressors are probably not long for this world either.
All right, there you go. Quinn, always great to hang out with you. Hey, thank you for the support, Mechanical Pros. Come back, check us out. Hopefully we'll show you this flush kit pretty soon, which I'm pretty excited about. And keep coming with the comments and questions. We love the feedback and the support. And check it next time on Mechanical Pros.